back to Spoonful Easy Cooking. It's been a long gap, right? Yes, I was also very occupied with my kids' exams, work, everything. But Diwali is round the corner and we have to make some snacks. Everybody's at home. So let me show you some very simple and easy and yummy snacks which we can make at home to delight all our family members. So without much delay, I'll show you one special Maharashtrian snacks. Without this, Diwali is pew pew. So that is Shankarpale. Okay, for that I'll show you the easiest and quickest method how to make it. So what we do is we take a pan here, and what we are going to do is we lit it, and here I have taken equal measurements. This measurements I have taken so that you will remember. All equal. Sugar one bowl, water one bowl, and ghee one bowl. So all these measurements you can just check my description box. It is for your easy convenience, I am telling. One bowl of sugar we added to the pan, one bowl of water, and one bowl of ghee. This is my homemade ghee. Yeah. Here we have added all these ingredients. Some people even add milk to it, but the shelf life of the if you're making with milk, the shelf life of the Shankarpare goes very less. Like one, in 2 or 3 days you have to consume. Without milk it will remain for long days, like at least for 2 to 3 weeks it will remain fresh. To this we add a pinch of salt and we'll allow this mixture to heat it up so that all the sugar gets dissolved completely. Keep it on medium flame and let's give a stir in between. Once the sugar dissolves, we'll switch off the gas. Now the sugar is completely dissolved. Now we'll switch off the flame and keep this mixture to cool down. We kept this for cooling down. Slight warm is no problem. We'll add this to the container where we are going to mix the dough. This is slightly warm now, but we can handle it. Have taken a refined flour. There is no quantity to the refined flour. We will add this refined flour little by little to this mixture and keep stirring this way. And finally we'll make dough out of it. This way slowly stir into this mixture. We mix this along with a spoon and just see the consistency. It should be like a soft chapati dough. So this is slightly, see if you can see, it is sticky but it's slightly thin consistency. Right, so you need to add little more refined flour and adjust. Now you can handle the temperature. Now just make a smooth dough out of this. Our soft dough is ready. See, this is very soft and it already have started giving a nice aroma of the ghee. See, you, my hands are also well clean. There is no dough on to it. Now what we do, you don't have to rest this. The best thing of Shankarpale is that you don't have to rest this dough. Just keep it this way open, no need to even keep a lid. Keep it this way and let's keep the kadai for frying, deep frying. So here we take the kadai and we'll pour the oil and keep it ready. So the dough is ready. Our ladle, everything is ready to roll it. Now the oil is also getting ready. It's getting hot. I've kept it on a sim right now. We can keep it little on a high. And here is some one plate with tissue paper. Okay. So let's divide this dough. The Shankarpale needs to be little thick. This much thick. I'll show you. Don't make it too thin nor too thick. We don't need any powder as such. If we need, we can just take it.
But here we just take it this way and roll it. So we have rolled this into a chapati. Now you can see, this is the thickness you need to maintain. This way we need to roll and cut it into square. The shapes is as per your wish, you know. It can be square, it can be diamonds, anything. So what we do, the edges, we'll just give a cut this way. If you have a nice designer, knife, you can do with that. Now I'm quickly showing you. The edges, you can cut it so that you get a good shape. There we go. Now we got a nice square. Now it just gives stripes this way. You can make squares simple. I'm making simple squares this way. See? Done. Now we need to check the temperature of the oil. Oil's temperature is very important. What we do, this is a small tip. Just keep it on high temperature and slide one diamond and check it. One shankarpali and check it. Yes, the oil is hot. So keep it on sim right now while adding. Be very careful. Just slide all of them. Make sure you maintain this thickness. See, it is not very thick nor thin. Then only the right taste of shankarpali will come. Keep it on medium flame and give a slight stir this way so that it evenly cooks. It will take approximately 5 minutes to cook both the sides. So just keep stirring this way. Don't keep it on high flame. On medium flame it's perfect. Nor don't keep it on low flame also. Just medium is fine. It's almost the stage. You can see it is slight brown. Don't make it too dark brown. Otherwise there will be burnt flavor. So this is fine. We'll take it out.
Mama, this is my favorite Diwali snack. And I call it the diamond snack.
Yes, this is Madi's diamonds. When she was small, she used to call it as diamonds. So here is our first batch of shankarpali. This is perfect and it looks also perfect. The best way to know how the shankarpali should taste is, should look and feel it is crispy from out and inside it should be slightly soft. And that's the right shankarpali. See, there is no oil which is absorbed. It's all perfect. See?
Wow.
Yes. Similarly, let's make the other ones also. So finally, after half an hour, we have all prepared our shankarpali and the house is, my God, with full aroma and it's really turned out to be very great. So Riyar, my little munchkins have come for the Diwali vacation. So for all of you, I prepared shankarpali. All of you can taste it. Take little rose.
Yummy.
You like shankarpali?
Yeah.
Okay. So the Diwali season has started. All of you must watch Spoonful Easy Cooking for more exciting snacks. Till then, bye-bye. Enjoy the Diwali.
Bye.